What's up, guys? Welcome to more Skyrim mods. Today we are going to be doing Rendspire Palace. Now, this mod is truly incredible, really. This is absolutely amazing. It was done by Shoeski 11. I want to say I got that right. But this mod is huge, and I mean huge. It's only 1.8 megabytes, but the amount of stuff they added, for how well it's done, and for how little frame rate lag there actually is, I was very, very impressed. Now, it's near Whiterun, and you end up going to the Canyon of Tears, I want to say that it is. And basically what you're doing is, you go to this place, and it's a separate location from itself. Like, it separates itself from the world. You have to go to the Canyon of Tears, and then the palace is actually inside it. Okay, that actually didn't do anything I expected. Like, it's something to get triggered. But basically, you gotta wait for me to go further in. Alright, Canyon of Tears, yep. So, in there is a massive, massive, massive palace. Like, this thing is enormous. Now, it isn't a carbon copy, but the layout is the same as the Solitude Palace. It isn't the same thing, though. Trust me, there's so much more to this that is just incredible of how much they actually added into this game, or into this mod. This is by far one of my favorite mods I've ever seen. And, sorry, I'm like sneezy, coughing, sick. But basically right here, we'll find this guy.
This one needs something.
Don't know what he is. I think he might be the merchant you sell things to.
How can I assist?
I think he's the merchant you sell things to. I didn't go back and check. But basically, you kind of follow along the path. This is just such an incredible mod. I can't wait to like just get more in depth with the mod because with how much this is. I think I recorded, 30 minutes worth of stuff in this one mod alone. Because there's just so freaking much. But really, this is going to take a while, so I'm going to be doing a lot of, not a lot of platforming, but it's just got a lot of traveling. But basically, yes, the face textures are messed up. That's been a common problem with most of the mods, but it doesn't bug me too much. But really, there are a lot of standing stones you can go check out. So I'm going to go fast forward, and so maybe you could see these standing stones for yourself. So I'm going to make a time lapse. Now, all the standing stones do work, and it does give you perks. I just thought that was a little interesting little feature they added to the game, to the mod. So, we're inside the castle now. You've seen that it was locked, but you have a key with it, and I forgot with the key, you also get a note. This note is fairly long. I actually read the entire thing. It was pretty cool. Very, very lore-friendly. I really enjoyed that. It completely follows all of the lore. I have no idea, and I don't have checked, but I have no idea if it follows your decisions in Skyrim of what you did or what you didn't do. I'm guessing it didn't, but saying he's a loyal Imperial, sorry if you're a Stormcloak fan, I'm an Imperial kind of guy, I like the Empire, I like Rome, I like that kind of stuff, so I picked the Imperials. Oh my gosh, I feel like I need to sneeze. I have no idea how loud that will sound. I took my head away from the mic so you didn't have to hear me. Oh man, I've been so sick for like a week and a half now. I'd really appreciate not being sick anymore. But this is a great, great letter, kind of explaining why everything goes on. That's where you get your key as well. Key, and I'm using air quotes. It comes with a letter, and I'm using air quotes again. You can't see me, but that's what I'm doing. Oh man, I hate recovering after a sneeze. Oh man, so really, the things this mod has in store are just ridiculous, and I mean that they are. The stuff that is in this is just absolutely outrageous, and I think you would all agree with me that already there's so much stuff in the game. Like, you have your own personal guard, and then you have your own. You have your own freaking, like, standing stones and gear boosts, and it's like any standing stone you would use, really. I use the lover stone because it gives you all perk, it levels up perks faster for everyone, but, like, there's just so much more. Right here, we got sort of a dungeon. This is going to be the dungeon aspect of the game, and I think it combines the dungeon from Castle Dower and the actual palace to the game.
Mm-hmm.
And you have your little executioner guy here kind of running everything, and
what do you need?
Really, it's just, I'm guessing these are, I can't see too well.
Until next time.
I got a bad, bad glare. But I'm guessing these people are just gonna be the people that live down here. I'm guessing she runs the bar maybe down here, because there's gonna be a bar. I didn't nearly explore this mod as much as I did in the video. I left that up to some of you guys, because I explore all the sub-levels, basically. I don't explore any of the wings, so I left it up for you guys to explore. But that just goes to show how massive this mod is. I go through all the dungeon areas and everything like that. Right here, you kind of see him. He's like, oh yeah, blah, blah, blah. Basically, they just have the same dialogue as any other regular guard, and nothing really impressive.
I know you're kind. Always sneaking
didn't
want to
get spotted. I don't know if they get aggroed over things like that. And, you know, I own the palace, but you know what? Be safe. Gosh, I gotta pick this. Fuck. Damn it. I'm having unlimited lockpicks, like, or having unbreakable lockpicks. It's such a nice, and I've been spoiled with it. And come on, there we go. Got it. Now we got a key.
It's a place for Nord dead.
Don't know why third person. All right, so that leads to the North Wing or Armory. And this leads down to the foundation. We'll all go to that later on in the game. So first of all, we just got to explore a little bit more. I'm going to go a little bit more into the dungeon. Really, I'm just checking to see what each door does. And this is just a list of everyone who lives here. Well, literally everyone who lives here. Kind of awesome. You got a lot of people here. I thought it was really funny. You have a priest. You even have a priest. Like, the fuck? Like, okay. This is your captain of the guard over here.
Need something?
Nice Khajiit. You can tell him to follow you. I like Khajiits. I really do. Khajiits are nice. Mm-hmm. They're cute. They're badass. And they're awesome. But,
yes, Stoliki.
This is such
you?
A just massive mod. Now, we're going to go back down to the dungeons real quick. Now, this is where I think it's from Castle Dower. Even has prisoners in it, which I didn't open or try to test because I didn't know if they were going to be hostile. Hello! So, I didn't open anything yet. Yeah, so, really, that's just the same thing throughout, and I just kind of show it off. And in here, in the other room across, we have a little torture chamber. Of course. You got a little dead prisoner there, and blood everywhere. Hear the dragging of a bone in the background. That is my dog. Wait, did I just get lost? Yeah, you're definitely gonna hear that. Oh, I always love recording when I have my puppy here. She's loud. She's cute. Oh, not my puppy. But yeah, okay, so we're gonna continue on with the exploration of the actual palace in itself, and we're gonna go to the armory. Now, probably one of the more favorite of the aspects, because the armory, you get to store all your stuff and show off all your stuff.
It ain't true what they say about you and...
I think that's going to be most people's favorite. I like the little nocturnal thing. You didn't need the little statue nocturnal there, but they, you know, like, here, I have it anyway. But we're just going to kind of go through, and they're all guards. They're not, even if they look different from a guard, they're still a guard, and I've noticed that that is some sort of trend. I actually accidentally clicked. I forgot about that. But yeah, we'll explore this another time. We'll just kind of turn around. we'll explore that another time. For now, we're going to be doing this. Okay. So, we're going to look down here, and literally, just like,
damn dragons could swoop down at any
massive, 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 massive palace you have here. Or armory you have here. You can literally store anything here. It's awesome. I love that. That just whole aspect is enormous. So we'll go to the foundation now. The foundation is actually very interesting because I never expected it to turn out the way it did. We'll move down to it once I get through. I actually had some trouble like figuring out what the hell is. I thought this was it, and I was like, wow, this kind of sucks when I saw this little opening here. And that leads to sub-level east, which we've already been to. Yeah. Just see this little bridge over here, and I'm just like, what the hell is this? Kind of crossover. I like how they have the blaze armor, by the way. I think that's really cool. And they have a little church! And I was like, oh shit, they have the church! It's where the priest works. And I was like, okay, that's awesome! I like how they added that. Like, it's a cool little place. That was, to me, just one of the, like, better details. And I was just like, okay, that's awesome. I like that, you know. And so you gotta go back up. And there's a door that leads to sub-level east, like I said earlier. But I'm gonna go back. But then I found this. The training quarters. I was like, alright, this is new. We'll go to the training quarter. Which is another sweet area. I mean, this entire palace is enormous. I can't really grasp how amazing this mod is. Like, this is probably my new favorite mod of all I've explored, because it just adds so much and it's so cool, and like, it's very, very lore friendly, and it's just for how well it's done, it's very good. Like, there's so much stuff here. Like, the guard looks like a normal man, but I couldn't say enough. Like, respawning arrow chest. I thought that was cool. I love that they did that. It's like, arrows are always a bitch to get. Well, good arrows, I should say. I don't have to craft dragon bone arrows every 4 freaking seconds. I'm somewhat of an arrow guy. I like arrows. I'm like half an archer, more warrior kinda. But really, we're just going to explore a little bit more. That leads back to the foundation, and I'm just kind of traversing around, trying to figure out what's where. You have a nice little like kitchen-esque area. Don't really know what it's for, but yeah, I think this is where the guards stay
what
and sleep.
It? Dragons?
Considering they're all the beds, and then they're sleeping guards. But yeah, we're going to make a sharp right, and then continue on. With our day. Do I get the guard through the... So, pretty much, I was just looking for a way out, and we go here. Sub-level west. So we've been to the east, and now we're going to the sub-level west. So, take some time. Not that much time, but glad they fixed the loading screens in this game. Boom. So, sub-level west. What is in the sub-level west? This is basically where everyone else stays and that is exists in your palace. This is where your steward is, this is where your bard is, this is where your cooks are, your bartender. This is where your...
Yes?
I'm trying to think, their priest stays. This is where everyone else in this
all
place
right,
stays. This is where they reside. So... Thought that was really cool. They just, you know, added everything else back into the game. Everyone is sleeping, so I just woke everyone up. Got a nice little armory again. Yeah, I was like wondering who lived there. Forgot you had your own blacksmith also in this game. Your own blacksmith to kind of fix things up when you need it. Liked that. Just kind of looked around at what he had, you know. There's so much in this mod. There's the bone drop again. I'm actually going to go pick up my bone for her. Because she's going to be loud and obnoxious if I don't. Right, girl? There's your bone. She might have licked my mic. I'm confused. But yeah, you know, this is such a great, this little like meeting area, I guess, is in a sense. You get more guards. I thought there was something else because they were dressed different, but they're not. I'm just trying to explore and just show off how much this mod actually has. It's really incredible.
I heard you were
and there's
the
bone again. All right. There's no stopping her now.
Codlac Whitemane is in a better place now.
Yeah, you got your bar there, and so we're gonna. I forgot where you go to next. I really do, but.
So you what? Watch the skies, traveler.
Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot I tried to pick this, which I don't know why. I was like, oh, gotta crouch. I have a key. I was like, oh yeah. So, go to the steward's quarters, and. Yeah, I forgot your steward has a separate location. I messed that up last time, but your steward does have a separate location than your person, than everyone else, basically, and can get through here. Steward has a nicer area. There you go. He doesn't say much. You can just kind of talk to him, and then really, that's all he does. He doesn't have any like personal conversations you can have with. But you know, Rendspire dungeon key. Like he has a bunch of keys there, and. That was kind of a test to see if he would get aggro too, but he did not. And I was just like, I don't know if I can go through these doors, because it might trigger something, because I don't want to go somewhere else. But this leads to the Lord Chamber's private quarters, which I thought was cool. And that's basically what both doors lead to, and that leads to the Great Hall. And that also leads to the Great Hall. So, we're going to go to the Lord Chamber's private quarters, which is probably one of the coolest parts of this mod is... This place is incredible. Kind of venture
whatever
in further
need,
in.
Dragonborn,
whatever you need,
word.
Dragonborn, say the word. but this is so cool. You got a Lord's Bath, which I'll show later. Like, you go through here, and you have your living quarters. Like, you can just hang out, chill, have fun. Then down there, you have the bed and everything. And this is just such an incredibly large mod. So much. This is such beautifully done. I love this whole thing. Just, it's so massive. And I thought later on you'll see me trying to get in some cabinets. I think it's, I don't know if it's right here at this moment. Because these cabinets seem really out of place. You can't open them. There's two of them. There's one at the other end. But you can't open the false back panel, which I feel like they're going to add later. Maybe get an alchemy station there. I don't know. Like, I thought it'd be cool if there was, like, a Dark Brotherhood in one and then Thieves Guild in the other. Maybe it's just me, though. Like, have a Dark Brotherhood room and a Thieves Guild room. Kind of, you know, just add a little, like, nod to that. Came in that way, so we'll walk out this way. So, this door, we walk in, and it will lead to the training quarters. So, it won't go through there. I was guessing there'd be another door over here, and I forgot about the Lord's Bath. So, we'll look at the Lord's Bath. Sorry if I just stop. I was actually answering a text from Mimuther, not right here. Right here, I wasn't paying attention, and I was like, oh, it's right. And I accidentally clicked the controller. This is Lord's Bath. This is awesome. You got a little waterfall. You go under, you got your little, like, literally a bath. But right here, I kind of get lost because I'm trying to answer a text, and at the same time, maneuver my way out. Didn't know how to get out until I realized stairs. So this looks very similar to the Falmore Embassy. Thought that mannequin was following me, got freaked out. Yeah, it leads back to the chambers, and you can go back. I mean, that's all they have in that area. So this leads to like an upper level portion of your chambers. I think this leads to the top of your chambers, I want to say. Yeah, it does. Because you go follow this little path, that leads back down. But this door leads to in here again. Actually, no, this leads to your office. I didn't even explore your office. I didn't explore it. This is your office. You have an office here now. I like how they have a Daedric Dagger. Just like, tsh, hey, Daedric Dagger, show power. Yep, ha. But you got some more bookcases. Got some more gold, gilded items. Yeah, but you have your own little personal office there too, which I thought was cool. So, we'll go to the Great Hall now. And this is going to be the last portion I actually explore. I don't explore the South Wing or the North Wing. I will leave that up to you guys because this mod is just so massive and I didn't want this video to be like 40 minutes long. I'm already about 25 minutes in right now. Ugh.
Hey.
I know who you are. I know who you are. So basically this is the throne room and it is very, very similar to the Solitude Throne. The Proud Spire Manor is your manor. Blue something castle, I don't know. Oh well. But yeah, very, very similar to the game. Go back here. This will lead to your steward's, the Lord's private chambers. Downstairs leads to your steward. Both ends will lead you back to your chambers, which is cool. I like that. Just kind of continuing there here will lead to the North Wing, and then down south will also lead you to your North Wing. Down south, I mean below you, not like actually down south. This will lead to the South Wing, right here, and then, thanks for dropping that right next to me there, girl. My dog dropping her, kicking her bone now. That leads to the South Wing. We're almost done. South Wing again, then back here, Lord, there's your steward's chambers. Oh, that's just making so much noise. Back here. You go to North Wing, and then you have another North Wing door, I think, on the right here. Yep, we got another North Wing, and then we get back to Steward's Quarters. And I think we're done. That is all we explored today in this mod. This has been Rendspire Manor. I want to say it's Rendspire. I think I got that right. But this mod is truly amazing. This has been hands down my favorite mod since I've been exploring mods. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you want more, please give this a like. And if you want to see more, please subscribe to my channel. And I will see you guys around. Peace. And now I gotta go take care of my dog.